Hey everybody, it's the Shape, back to another video. Now this video, it's one of those videos I didn't want to make, being 100% real with you. But that being said, let's go ahead and get into the video and you'll understand what I mean shortly. Roll the credits. See, I got an email. I can't remember the person that emailed. You know who you are. I appreciate you. Now, he brought to my attention a channel called Zark Scary Haunting. It's one of them channels that, you know, it's a family that is terrorized by an unseen spirit. Much like all these other channels that we see. You know, Ben and Lainey really haunted. The family's being this apparition, demon, whatever it is attacking the family and throwing stuff. You can't see it, but it's, you know, destroying the house. But this channel isn't very big, but you can really see, like, the 10 videos the guy has, they're short videos, slowly starting to gain an audience. But we're getting ready to squash it like a bug. Now let's take a look at his first clip. Now, as you can see, cabinets are opening, stuff's flying out of the cabinets, just the whole thing going on here. You know, the classic, something moves, something falls over, yet you just can't see anything. But that cubby hole in the main back, I want you to pay attention to the cubby hole, because all the paranormal footage mostly evolves around that blind spot. Now, as that last thing fell, you can see like a window or something behind it. And what do windows have? They have reflections, right? Or a mirror, whatever it is. I think it's a window. But I noticed something. Let's zoom in on the window. Now, if you look closely here, right there, you can see a shadow in the reflection. Let's look at it one more time. Now, there's definitely somebody moving in that little cubby hole. Yes, you see a reflection of somebody. Now, could it be the spirit of the house? Sure, it very well could be. There's not enough definition to argue that. Let's look again. Yeah, I think our guy's right over there. In all of his videos when he's not on camera, you can see the reflection of somebody. Oh, I mean, it could be a demon, but I'm just saying. Y'all see the shadow reflection, whatever it is? Now, like I said, it could be argued that that is the demon's reflection. Or shadow figure, whatever. Now let's look at the next clip, because it's an overlaid sound, you know, that we've done so many times. How do I know that? Just watch. Did you hear that? If not, we'll play it again. But what I wanted you to hear was the fact that he hears something run at him. And whatever it is barefooted. You know, like him being barefooted. Not only is it barefooted, this demon, spirit, ghost, shadow figure, but its run sounds identical to his. Let's listen one more time. Listen to it run at him and then listen to him run. Thank you. they're identical, which means he overlaid the sound, obviously. What he did is he went in that room, took his camera, and recorded himself run across the floor while he's standing, or he probably took the camera and put it right there where he's standing as it's running at him. But instead, he puts the camera on a tripod, he runs toward the camera, and then he goes in and films that, and he takes the sound and overlays it. It's that easy. It's that simple. I've done it in the past. I've showed you guys. But let's look at the next clip. It only gets better.
Mommy, Jenny troubling me.
I don't like it when people bring their kids into it anyways. The kid's playing along. He knows it's his dad in that back cubbyhole. Pulling the string and pulling that. I think the kid accidentally said daddy instead of Danny. Let's listen to it one more time.
Mommy, Jenny troubling me. Mommy, Jenny troubling me. Jenny,
there's nothing.
I can't see the book moving.
Comment below if you guys see a string, but I really don't see nothing in this particular clip. Now, one could argue, well, Shape, we didn't see the string, and you're right. I didn't see a string in that either. But let's look at this next clip. Now, our boy Zark, he hears that bicycle. It falls off the couch and he hears it and he mans up because he's about that life. So he gets up, grabs another camera. So now we have two cameras. And he's gonna go in there and he's gonna fend off this evil spirit like a man. And as you've seen from his camera view, as he walks in the room to investigate the bicycle, something behind him slides outwards. And like the man that he is, he turns around and hauls ass. Okay? Now, let's see the other camera angle. I'm sorry, that wasn't the real footage. I had to again. I'm sorry. I get bored. Did you catch it? Let's watch it again. If you look closely, you can see the fishing line. When he turns the flashlight, it shines. Right about there, you see that? See, the visuals never lie. The visuals show you what's on camera. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, you can literally see the fishing line. Running along the groove where the floor has square grooves all the way, you can see the string. Running as he turns with the flashlight, you can see the string shine. But you can also see the string where the chair was pulled. Let's take a look. This is where the chair was pulled. Now, as he first walks in the room, you can see the fishing line sparkling right there where the chair is getting ready to be pulled. And this is exactly how he has the fishing line run around the bottom leg of the couch. Yes, as he walks in the room with his flashlight, you can see the string right exactly where the chair is about to be pulled. Not only that, you can see exactly how they run the string because I showed you the one spot of the string and I showed you this spot of the string. He's got it wrapped around that couch, the leg of that couch, like a square. Shape, show a graphic to show exactly how he's got the string run. The string don't lie. That guy is 100% fake staging his videos. You can see the string with your own eyes. That was a bit of an easy one too. Sorry. Now, Chasing the Darkness, my YouTube friend Levy, he made a video where he caught a shadow figure. And I watched the video. Well, first, I seen Joe Vitale, my buddy, another YouTube friend, made a video just analyzing the shadow figure. And I said, you know what? I'm going to go watch that shadow figure. I kind of wish I hadn't, to be honest. Because, see, the fact of the matter is, well, you kind of get stuck between a rock and a hard place. This is no exception. And, yes, I could have went to his channel. I could have watched his video and just pretended, hey, I didn't see it. I didn't see the video. If I don't say anything, nobody would be the wiser, right? Nobody would know. But I would know. See, if I can't be unbiased, then I don't need to be doing this. I shouldn't even be doing any debunking. So I am going to put my findings in this video. And if Levy sends me like uncut stuff that I asked him for, I've already spoke to him, then I'll say, you know what, I was wrong. But let's get into this.
You hear that music playing? Hello? Is there any music playing? I think there's people here. Oh man, I hope my audio catches, because right here, I hope your audio catches it too, bro, because...
Now, as Levy is going down this hallway, you can clearly hear what sounds like one of them music boxes playing. Now, I want to say this straight out of the gate. Ghost Adventures had went to this place as well. They didn't catch no music box sounds, but they got these like a bell ringing over and over and over. Levy caught a shadow figure going right to left that's obstructed by a door. Zach Bagans called a shadow figure, except it was behind a stud wall. They looked and it went right to left as well. Just want to put that out there because I'm going to be transparent.
Hello? Anybody here? We just come to investigate this place. Music is wild.
Now, here comes the shadow figure. And I want you guys to pay attention to everything. I want you to pay attention to where Levy's standing when he catches it. I want you to pay attention to what he says right before it comes out. I want you to pay attention to how he shines the flashlight. All of it. I want you to pay attention to everything.
I know, man. So this doesn't feel right.
Dude, did you hear that? Dude.
It's like footsteps?
Footsteps.
Now, when I first saw that, it stood out to me like a sore thumb. Like the very first pass. It was like, I caught it instant. A lot of you guys will have too. That being said, let's let him zoom in to show you the shadow figure and let's really look at it. But let's do that. is you got two cameras in the hallway. You have the night vision camera and you have Levy's camera, the one with the light, just regular camera. And I want you to pay attention to the texts that he puts right before he shows you the night vision of the supposed shadow figure that he may have blocked. He said it could have been a kid, a small child, which it's not, as somebody being over. It's a grown man. It's not a shadow figure, it's a person in black or a hood, cape, whatever. But let's take a look. Now Levy says, can this be a small child? No, that's a grown person. A person or something else. And he also puts, when you see Joe's cam, which I'm getting ready to show you, supposedly Joe's cam, he says you can see nothing passing by. Unless, Levy says, unless he blocked it with his body, because his other guy was behind him a little bit. So you've seen all of that text, and I'm going to show you exactly what he shows as soon as he shows the text, saying, well, maybe I blocked the shadow figure, right? And I want you to look at it, because he's not standing in the same spot as the other camera. He's way further down the hall. First. Second, if you remember in his camera that Levy was holding, he says right before the shadow figure pops out, he says something like, I'm getting the creeps. And as soon as he says that and he shines the light in the right hand corner of the door, it walks out. But just watch.
Did you hear that?
Now, either Levy edited the wrong footage in there, or I had to say it, or he tried to sage it. Now, the reason I bring that up, now a lot of people aren't going to be happy, but like I said, I got to be honest and truthful, and if I see something that I question, I got to put it in a video, no matter who it is. But he's not standing in the same spot. He's way further down the hall when the supposed shadow figure comes on the night vision. Now, one could argue that if he did have the wrong footage, this was him further down the hall. So maybe he's showing the shadow figure and then immediately showing what happened after. But the problem is, you can hear the shadow figure walk across the floor when you turn the volume up. And the guy holding the night vision camera reacts to it, said, I heard footsteps. So this had to be like right after. So something ain't making sense. This can't be the night vision of the shadow figure. Levy's in a different spot. He's shining the flashlight in the wrong spot. Everything's different. We'll watch it again. And I'm going to show you Levy's footage of his camera. But unless he can teleport all the way, you know, from being way in front of those two doors on both sides of the hall to all the way down, way in front of them, I don't know. But let's look again. And I want you to watch where he shines the flashlight, and when he says something, just watch what he says, then he shines the flashlight, and then the figure walks up.
I know, man. So this doesn't feel right.
As the shadow figure walks out, Levy keeps the flashlight beam on this door panel. Yeah, he says, this doesn't feel right. Something doesn't feel right, right before the shadow figure. Now, you know, in past videos, I said people will talk to cue whoever's hiding to come and walk, do the paranormal for them. They'll say something like, you know, ooh, I'm creeped out. And then that's that person's cue to do whatever paranormal fakery they're going to do. I'm not saying that's what he did. I'm just saying, but I had to point that out because that's what I do. But I want you to look at these screenshots. See, this is where Levy was standing when he captured the shadow figure. You see those two doors? Now, this is where he's standing on his buddy's camera. He's past the doors. He would have to be in this range for that to be correct. Like I said, human beings can't teleport. And he says in his video, let's look at Joe's cam because I think I blocked the figure. And it's not the same footage as when he's holding the camera. It's two different ones. He's not, you know, and I'm going to give him the benefit of the doubt and say, well, maybe he just put the wrong clip in. That's fine. We could say that. And if I'm wrong, I'll make a video on it and say, hey, I was wrong. And I asked him for the right footage because that's got to be the wrong footage. Like I said, people can't teleport.
I know, man. So this doesn't feel right.
Whew. Well, dude, did you hear that? Dude.
Now, the only logical thing is if, you know, it wasn't being staged, and like I said, I'm not saying he staged it. If he's got the footage, he'll show everybody because he's real, right? He could say, well, I just put the wrong clip in the video, you know? However, I would love to see the night vision of the shadow figure walking by, because it's not in his video, even though he said it was. It's not, because it's two different clips. Now this is Levy before he sees the shadow figure. Now look where he's standing in the hallway as he sees the shadow figure, right here. Now you can see both doors on both sides. Now when we switch camera angles to show a different perspective of the shadow figure, look where he's standing. Two totally different places. Now it's not, you know, one camera with a wider lens making it seem that way. You can look at the doors on each side and tell he's in two different spots, obviously, and he's not doing the same movements or anything. Now that being said, like I said, he could have put the wrong clip in. I'm gonna give him the benefit of the doubt, and if he uploads it to his channel for everybody to see, which hopefully he does, maybe uncut of both footages before and after the shadow figure walks by, then I'd be like, hey, I'm wrong. But I also want to point out what it looks like through those doors where the shadow figure walks by, because he walks down there. But this is the inside of the double doors where the shadow figure is. You can see corridors on both sides. Any human could be standing in, if it was a human being, a homeless guy. Now, that being said, now, like I said, Levy could have uploaded the wrong clip. But if he did, he needs to correct that because it looks horrible. We need to see the night vision. See, the problem is Levy never shows Joe's cam. He never shows the shadow figure on the night vision of his buddy's camera. He says it unless he blocked it with his body, and then he shows this clip. But the problem is that's not the same clip as the other when he sees the shadow figure. He's standing in a different spot. He ain't shining the shadow or the flashlight the same way. There's just too many questionable things, and hopefully Levy can fix it. I like Levy a lot. I hope I'm wrong, and I hope he uploads the night vision of the shadow figure. That way he can correct me, and I'll make a video saying that. I also want to point out that the night vision camera would have showed the shadow figure in much more detail. And like I said, Levy could have uploaded the wrong clip by accident. We'll have to find out, but I got to see that night vision. Now, one more recap. I want you to look at where Levy's standing. And then when he shines, I want you to look at where he shines the flashlight in the right panel of that upper panel of that door. He keeps it there as the shadow figure walks by. Now, but when they jump to this, Levy says I could be blocking the shadow figure, but he never shines that flashlight on the upper right panel of the door. And plus his buddy reacts to hearing the footsteps. Obviously, there's plenty of places somebody could walk from one side to the other. There's passages that way, and a passage that way, and a passage that way. So, but like I said, this is just my opinion, and I'm sure you guys would be scratching your head like, well, you're making a good point, because he's obviously not in the same places on those two clips. That being said, all of his other parts, when he cut back and forth from the night vision to his camera, were perfect, except for the most important part where this shadow figure is. That being said, like I said, maybe he put the wrong clip in, but maybe he'll upload it, and I'll look at it, and you'll look at it, and I'll just say, you know what, you're right, I was wrong, and I'll make a video saying I was wrong. I mean, I like Levy, have nothing against him, but this stood out to me, and if I didn't do a video on it, like I said, I don't need to be debunking if I'm going to be biased about it. Period. That being said, I love you guys. I appreciate all you do. Thank you very much. And like I said, I hope I'm wrong. And I hope he uploads when the shadow figure walks by on the night vision. I ain't talking about his camera. The night vision. Like a minute before and after, uncut. And I'll be like, okay, I was wrong. I love you guys. I appreciate you. And I'll see you in the next video. Peace. Y'all come back now, you hear? Secret word is, huh? Lunchbox.